أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله، أما بعد، يقول سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه الكريم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، فكل ضلالة في النار. أما بعد، respected brothers and sisters, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to gather this masjid, to gather us here on Qiyamah of Sayyidina Mursaleen Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ameen. A simple question that consists of two words. If you ask it to different kinds of people from different fields of life, you will get a lot of different answers, and maybe some similar. The question is, then what? Then what? ثم ماذا? You ask a student, then what? As you graduate, then what? Go to college, then what? I'll find a job, then what? I'll get married, then I'll have children. You ask a person who, a doctor, then what? I'll have my own clinic, then what? I retire, then what? Everybody has their own answers. But there is a point where all people wind up answering the same answer. Then what? Then I die. They will all meet at that answer, no escape. Muslim, non-Muslim, Arab, non-Arab, black, white, rich, poor. At the end, when you keep going with the question, the final answer to everybody is, I will die. No one in this room, or no one I know, or no one you know, has ever said, I'm going to live forever. So this is definitely the answer, the last answer of the conversation. Fine. If you ask the same question afterward, then what? Now the answers are limited to two. No more variety of answers. The answers are limited to two, Jannah or Na. After that, the answer is limited, either heaven or hell. يَوْمَئِذِي يَتَفَرَّقُونَ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, on that day they are separated. And another surah, he said, فَرِيقٌ فِي الْجَنَّةِ Allah اجعلنا منهم. وَفَرِيقٌ فِي السَّعِيرِ One group in Jannah, يَا رَبِّي make us all amongst them. And one group in hell, may Allah save us from hell. And save our parents from hell. So everyone knows and believes that death is coming. And when we say, like if I call you from Long Island, and then I told you on the phone, I'm coming. What does that mean? That means every minute that goes by, I'm getting closer. Whatever is coming, that means it's getting closer. And when we know, all of us, that death is coming, that means it's getting closer. Every breath I take brings me one step to my grave. Every breath, every day that goes by, I'm one day closer to my death, whether you like it or not. And unfortunately, we all know that. All of us know that. Another question. What are you doing about it? What are you doing about it? Somebody's coming. If I tell you I'm coming, or you have a guest that's coming, you prepare to welcome them. You prepare for their company. Now we all know, no one is going to say, I ask this question here, no one will say, I'm not going to die. And everyone knows. كُلُّ نَفْسٍ ذَائِقَةُ الْمَوْتِ كُلُّ نَفْسٍ. The king is going to die. The president is going to die. The poor man is going to die. The white, the black, the rich, the poor. كُلُّ نَفْسٍ. Everyone. The angels. Everything. Every creation will perish. And only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be left. Subhanahu. كُلُّ نَفْسٍ. Every soul is going to taste that. What are we doing about it? What are we preparing for this major 100% reality that's coming? What am I doing? Before we talk about that, let's remind ourselves, why are we here? It's very important every once in a while to remind myself and all of us, remind ourselves, why are we here? What are we doing? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not a coincidence that in Surah Al-Dhariyat he said, وَذَكِّرْ فَإِنَّ الذِّكْرَ تَنْفَعُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. And remind them, because the reminder does not benefit anybody. Some of you are going to benefit from this khutbah. Some of you are not going to benefit anything. It goes from here, it goes from here. Allah said, ذَكِّرْ. The benefit will, the reminder will benefit the believers. The true believer will leave from this khutbah with a plan. And the others will say, mashallah, it was good, and continue this life. And then right after that, Allah says, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. Is that a coincidence? After Allah told Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam to remind the Sahaba, the best of people, remind them. And then right after that, Allah told us the reason for our creation, the reason for our existence. I only created you so you can worship me. That's the only reason Allah created jinnkind and mankind. The only reason is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Am I fulfilling the purpose of my existence? Am I doing my job that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put me on earth to do? Ya Akhwan, let's think about it. We are all mature and educated people, alhamdulillah. Is it possible that Allah created me? I can eat and drink and go to work and go back to sleep and go to the bathroom. So what's the difference between me and any donkey? Donkey gets up in the morning, he walks, he sleeps, he goes to the bathroom. What's the difference? Is it possible? Just to eat and drink? No, ya Habib. No, ya Habib. No. We are more noble than that. We are here to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when we say worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that does not mean at all staying in the masjid 24 hours. No. A lot of people think, oh brother, leave us alone, ya akhi. You always ask us to do this, 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 and that. No, habibi. You can change every action in your life from ada into ibadah, adding one letter. You can change everything in our life from a habit to a form of worship. How? By making a good intention. Supporting your family and bringing food to the house is a must on you. When you leave, before you leave the house, you make an intention, Ya Allah, you have blessed me with a wife and children, and I'm going to my halal job, so I can bring them halal income and feed them. All your time at work will become ibadah, an act of worship. And while you're at work, you're lowering your gaze, you're controlling your tongue, you're controlling what you're hearing, and you're acting and behaving as a Muslim, every step, every moment of that day will become ibadah. You're a student going to college. Just before you sign for your major, you say, I am, Ya Allah, majoring to become a doctor, a lawyer, an engineer, an accountant. Ya Allah, to help my ummah. To help my ummah. So when the brother is looking for a doctor, he will look for a Muslim doctor and he will find him. When the brother is going through difficulty, he cannot pay, I will be there, Ya Allah, to help them. So Ya Allah, make this 6, 5, 7 years of my education easy. That 6, 7 years will become an ibadah. I'm going to the supermarket will become an ibadah just by making intention to support my family. So I can change everything to become an ibadah. And when I do that, I will be fulfilling the reason I am created. SubhanAllah. Then, when I'm doing that, I will increase the possibility on dying on husnul khatima, on having a good end. I will increase the possibility of husnul khatima. When you are always involved in ibadah, you are increasing the possibility to making your end as a good end. Because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, al-a'mal al-khawatim. The actions are judged by the way they end. If you fast from 4 o'clock in the morning and Maghrib is at 8 and you break your fast at 7:55, that fasting is not accepted. You have to finish till 8. Actions are by the way they ended. When you die on something, you will be resurrected doing it. You will die making talbiyah and hajj. You will be resurrected making talbiyah on the day of judgment. You die in a club, you will be resurrected drunk. It depends how do you die. So how can I prepare myself for this 100% event that's coming, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala kept its date, its place, only known to Him. لا تدري نفس بأي أرض تموت. Many of us, when we were born or when we are teenagers, never expected, never, whether in Guyana or in Pakistan or in Egypt, never expected I would be buried in Long Island or in Queens. Never. A brother was visiting his son from Egypt. His son is in Pennsylvania. The international airport is here, JFK. So he stopped here and then he's going to Pennsylvania. Haven't seen his son in 10 years. This man never been to America before. They took him to his son in Pennsylvania to the car of the dead people. He died by the JFK. Did this man know he's going to be buried in Pennsylvania? We all have dreams and hopes and long amal, which is nothing wrong as long as you are doing it according to the Kitab and Sunnah. What should we do? When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked by Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiallahu anhu wa Allah, he came and he asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam a question that every single Muslim would love to know the answer for. He said, Ya Rasulullah, guide me to something that will lead me to Jannah and will keep me away from hell. Everyone, every true believer would love to hear the answer from the best man ever created. Not from a professor in Harvard. No. From Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the teacher of mankind. The first man entering Jannah. Our guide to Jannah. He said, "Ya Ma'an, you asked about something very big, very major, very important. And it is easy to whosoever Allah will give you. Ya Allah, make it easy for yourself."
He
said, "First, Ya Ma'an," and keep in mind the words of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they can be written with gold. It won't be enough. Because the order he gives a statement is extremely important. So, Ya Mu'ad, number one, لا تشرك بالله شيئا. If you move forward, move forward. Ya Mu'ad, do not associate any partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now some of you are saying, but move to the second one, because already, alhamdulillah, we only worship one Allah. Let's go to this next one. No, do you have a blue eye in the house, hanging at the door for protection? Do you have it in your car? Do you go to the graves and ask people for help? Do you make tawaf around the graves? Do you go to a man that died 500 years ago and tell him, bless me with a baby boy, cure my son? Then you are committing shirk, and you don't know it. Sisters, how many times you read the horoscope? You're going to have a bad day. Oh, alhamdulillah, I'm not leaving the house. It's good I read the horoscope before I leave. That's a form of shirk. لا يعلم الغيب إلا الله. No one knows the unseen except Allah. When you put something to protect your car or to protect your home, that means Allah is not enough for me. I need to have that blue thing. That is a form of shirk. That's how Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam started. Do not associate anyone with Allah. And when we say anyone with Allah, anyone with his attributes. Allah is Razzaq. When your boss tells you, no Jum'ah for you, Salaam alaikum. The job is done, out. Brother, I have a family, this, that. Ya Akhi, you are leaving it for the Razzaq. You're not leaving it for any other reason. You're leaving it because Allah ordered you to attend Jum'ah. He revealed the surah and named the Jum'ah. And in that surah he said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا نُودِيَ لِلصَّلَاةِ مِنْ يَوْمِ الْجُمْعَةِ فَاسْعَوْا Run! To the remembrance of Allah. Leave your business, leave everything. I guarantee you. How did this surah end? What's the last words of this surah? وَاللَّهُ خَيْرُ الرَّازِقِينَ Is that a coincidence? Allah is the best of providers. When you give up something for the sake of Allah, Allah will 100% replace you with something better. 100% no doubt. You ask politely, respectfully, your boss, but if he does not agree, and he makes it extremely hard, wallahi, I guarantee you, that Allah will replace you with a better job. And that's not only for Jum'ah. That's also for every single salah, which is our next point that Rasulullah SAW mentioned. Do not associate partners with Allah. وَأَقِمْ الصَّلَاةِ Rasulullah SAW, he never said, or in the Quran, never says pray. أَقِمْ الصَّلَاةِ Establish salah. Establish salah. Because there's a huge difference between صَلِّي pray and establish salah. When suddenly pray is mentioned in the Quran, it's not mentioned in a good way. وَيْلٌ not لِلَّذِينَ أَقَامُوا الصَّلَاةِ وَيْلٌ لِلْمُصَلِّينَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنْ صَلَاتِهِمْ سَاهُونَ Allah said, وَيْلٌ Wow! Major punishment to the people who pray and they neglect their prayer. I'm watching a movie, when it's finished, I pray more. Asr came, Maghrib came, I'm still watching the game. No specific, no valid reason. And the valid reasons are two. Only for men. Either you really forgot, or you slept. You slept at Duhur, you woke up at Maghrib, and you missed Asr. That's it. Qaza, ma qaza, this is all man creation. إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ كَانَتْ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ كِتَابًا مَوْقُوتًا. The salat on the believer is on time. Brother, but I come at night and I pray them all together. Ya Habibi, this is your own deen. Allah said there's a certain time for every salat. No, you are making your own deen. And the shaitan told you, isn't it better than not praying at all? He convinced you that, mashallah, you're praying. There's a lot of people who do not pray. So you thought you're doing something good. You can pray anywhere. Don't be scared. You're not doing anything wrong. You should be very proud that you're a Muslim. Allah has chosen you from millions to make you a Muslim, to grow in a Muslim family or to convert at a later age. This is a ni'mah from Allah. This is a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallahi, we living in the West, we should appreciate it so much. But Allah has chosen me to be a Muslim. Allah establishing the salah on its time. On time. Fajr is on time. My brothers and sisters, we reached a point that we believe that the salawat are four because most of us are missing Fajr. Most of us are missing Fajr, even though the salat is dark. بُرِكَ فِي أُمَّةٍ فِي مُكُورِهَا. Rasulullah said, the barakah will be bestowed on the people who get up early. And they start their day with the salat. Salat al-Fajr. Why are you sleeping, ya akhi? Why you skip it and you pray only when you wake up? You wake up at 8, you pray at 8. My sister, get up and walk, wake up your son who's 11 and 12 and your daughter who's 13 and 14. And we keep saying, no, no, haram, let them sleep. They are very tired, they have school. We wake them up for dunya matters, but for deen matters, it's okay, let them sleep. If you love your child, if you care about your child, you wake them up for Fajr. You get them used to from a young age. Brothers, you come to the masajid at Fajr, you find 5, 6, 10, 15 people. Why? Why you skip that salah? Do you know the reward of coming to Fajr and Jamaah? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rasulullah said, Allah will protect you the whole day. You are under the protection of Allah the whole day. Salat on time. Then Rasulullah kept on going. He said, and fasting in the month of Ramadan. And then he said about the zakat, giving them in charity. And then he said to go to Hajj, if you can afford it physically and financially. This is the Hajj season, my brothers. If you have the finance, if you have the money, and you have the health, and your family is safe while you're away, and you still did not go to Hajj, you are committing a major sin. The shaitan is going to keep telling you, delay it, yalla, next year when you're 40, when you're 50, when you're 70. When I was a kid, I thought that you're only allowed to go to Hajj when you're 60. Because this is when the atmosphere of our country. No, 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 who goes to Hajj now, 20? No, no, wait, wait. Allah, that's what I thought. If you can afford it physically and financially, this is a ni'mah that you have that many, many millions of Muslims dream about. They are dreaming to see the house of Allah, the Kaaba. And you have the finances and you have the health and you still delay. That's a major sin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you that then. Take advantage and thank him by performing the Hajj. أقول قولي هذا استغفر الله فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. بسم الله وحده الصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم continued the hadith and he said, then let me tell you. And he started talking about the Nawafil. He said, fasting is a junna. Fasting is a shield from hell. Today is one of the three white days of the Qadha. Many of us are fasting here today. Alhamdulillah, if you are fasting, that's great now. Following Ramadan, by maintaining it of 3 days of every single month, to thank Allah that He kept you alive to witness that month. Every month, 3 days, and we all know that the days are getting shorter. In a few weeks, it's going to be 4 days and 5 days for the Maghrib. Make intention to fast yet. Second, he said, and charity wipes the sin, just like water extinguishes the fire. Give for the sake of Allah. When the brothers ask you to help a masjid, do not keep saying to yourself, oh, they keep asking us. Ya akhi, wallah, it's for your own sake. Allah, give us this money to see what are we going to do with it. Give for the sake of Allah, hoping that Allah will extinguish your sins. Third, he said, وَقِيَامُ وَصَلَاتُ الرَّجُلُ وَصَلَاتُ الرَّجُلُ and the prayer of the man or the woman in the middle of the night is one of the best ibadat, qiyam al-layl. You just finished Ramadan and you were praying 20 rak'ah, 2-3 hours, no problem. Does not make any sense to go from that peak all the way down to zero. 2 rak'ah only before Fajr, before the time of Fajr comes. And make dua in that 2 rak'ah. This is when the time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends to the first sky in a way that befits His Majesty. And He asks, what do you want so I can give you? Why don't you be amongst the people who at that time are asking Allah whatever you want, asking for Jannah for your family, asking for a righteous wife, asking for righteous children, asking for money, ask for whatever you want. Ask, this is the time to ask. Then Rasulullah, he said, shall I tell you about the sinan, the peak of all this? He said, al-Islam. He said, al-Islam. And the jihad fi sabilillah, struggling and striving for the sake of Allah. And then he said, alayhi salatu wasalam, after he mentioned all these things we spoke about, he said, shall I tell you about the foundation of all that? Shall I tell you about the foundation of all that? After he mentioned salat and siyam and jihad and zakat and hajj, should I tell you about the foundation of all that? أمسك عليك هذا. Control your tongue. Allahu Akbar. Control your tongue. Control your tongue. I was talking to a brother. I mentioned that in my last khutbah last week. A brother who's a doctor. And I was asking him, when you go around in the hospitals, you definitely see a lot of cases that remind you of how blessed you are. He said, absolutely. I told him, what is the case that really shocked you? And he said, Allahu Akbar, I never thank Allah for something like this. I always take it for granted. He said, there are so many. But I'll mention something that happened a few weeks ago. I went into intensive care and I saw a young man in his 20s. Everything is moving, his hands and arms, heart pumping, everything is good. But, and when I'm saying this, I want every single one of us to ask himself, when is the last time you thanked Allah for this man? He said, he has severe dry mouth syndrome. Allah. You know what that means? His mouth does not produce enough saliva to be able to talk. When is the last time I said, thank you, Ya Allah, I have enough saliva? When? So because of that, he weighs, he thinks about every single word he says. Why? Because if he talks too much, the lips start cracking. Can we from now on, every time we speak, we think that this is very valuable. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى ما ينفر من قول إلا. There's not one word you say except it is recorded and watched. Every single word, whether it's a praise of Allah or whether it's a curse, it is recorded. Every single word is recorded. Every word, every lie, every backbiting, every namima, every fatwa that you give, mashallah. Somebody ask a question. All of a sudden, you have 30 people, you have 35 mufti. Everybody knows everything about the deen. Well, somebody ask somebody back and you don't know. I do not know. Don't say to yourself, I am Sheikh, I am big, my beard is this big, how can I say no? No. The moment you start giving fatwa without ilm, without knowledge, you are putting yourself in a major, major sin. تَقُولُوا عَلَى اللَّهِ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Control this. This small part of the Bible could be the reason to enter Jannah, and it could be the reason to enter hell. So the bottom line, to prepare myself for death, obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and obey His Messenger. تنصر الله ينصر ويثبت الله. If you make Allah first in your life, first, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make you victorious. Allah will make us victorious. Put Allah first in your life, yeah. Put Allah first. Praise all calmly. Give your prescribed zakat. Go to Hajj if you can. Treat your wife with respect. My sister, treat your husband with respect. Raise your children on Islam. Raise your children on Islam and don't worry. Don't say it's too hard, it's too complicated, it's too extreme. Wallahi, if you hear the cases, our brothers and sisters, wallahi, you will cry. How many sisters are coming home pregnant? Pregnant! Without marriage! Raise your children on Islam. Put your trust in Allah. And your Allah will find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala supporting you all the way. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all from the people of Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from the people who listen. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا واسرافنا في امرنا وثبت اقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. ربنا هب لنا من ازواجنا وذرياتنا قرة اعين واجعلنا للمتقين اماما. اللهم انصر الاسلام واعز المسلمين. اللهم انصر الاسلام واعز المسلمين. اللهم يا ارحم الراحمين اتنا في الدنيا حسنه وفي الاخره حسنه وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد اذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمه انك إن الله وملائكة يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. فقم صلي على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. وقوم